Okay, we're recording.
Hello.
How is everybody tonight?
Good.
Wait, who is that?
I'm Crystal Beam.
Oh, hey, Crystal. Let me mute you. I'm sorry. You're awesome, but I'm going to mute you. There we go. Hey, Shannon.
Hey, Kaye. Thank you for having a call with us tonight. We're excited.
Yes, yes, yes. I want to give you guys what you need, what you feel. Bust out some March goodness. So Shannon, let's get started. Where do you want to start tonight?
Okay, so what I would love for you to do, we have a lot of new people on the team. So I'd love for you to just kind of maybe share your story, how you got started. If you want, you can share a little bit about like just even us and how we met, you know, or I can share that as we go along. But then mainly, the main thing is really just what we should be doing, you know, focusing, what we should be focusing in March. I was excited because I looked earlier just to kind of give you a rundown. We've had over 120 new enrollments, you know, just in the last 5 days on our downline. And so for us, that's really big. So we're really excited about that. You know, that's customers and distributors. And so, you know, I just think people are running and working, and I want to them to get some kind of words of wisdom from you as well.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely. I'm going to do a shortened version of my story for you guys. In respect to, for those of you that don't know it, what I really want to share is why I got started, because the obvious is I'm Pam Sowder's daughter. That's the obvious. You know, I was 12 when she discovered the rap. So we're looking at, you know, if you look at It Works having its 16th year anniversary today, 16 years is really awesome. And I look back at all of these years and think, wow, I was 12. So for those of you that have kids, you know, think about like your kids looking up at you or family members looking up at you and just being proud of everything you're creating. My mom changed the face of our family. She's forever changed the way that our family operates and lives life and believes in life and life's adventures and what we can create. And so I give her so much credit for that, for our growth. It's not just like a financial journey, right? It's a spiritual journey and realizing that we're so in charge of creating the most amazing life. And I want you guys to realize that as a mom now at 29 years old, I am so proud of what she did, because she truly kept her blinders on. And she, you know, we were talking, I was at her house today. I always go over on Sunday when she's in town and take Kennedy. And she was talking about, if you really want to excel and move forward and do something big, you literally have to do this. Like, you have to be the person that just kind of plows through. And I feel like that right now. And she knows that. And that's why she was sharing that with me. It's like that desire to compare and to what are they doing and what are they doing is gone. And it's like head down, blinders on, forward focused, all in. That mentality will take you so far. Because anybody that says no, or anybody that laughs or points their finger, it doesn't, you don't even see it. The thing is, it's not even that it doesn't bother you. It's like, you don't even see it. It doesn't matter. And I know that's why she has been so successful, and Mark too, but I'm just talking about this from a mother-daughter perspective. That's why I know she's been so successful, is because she has kept her blinders on and been so focused and so driven at her vision of what she wants out of life. And you know, looking forward into this month and looking at this next year, you guys have to know what you want to be proud of. Like, you have to know what you want to be proud of. What do you want to accomplish? Because that matters. It's like our financial guy sat down with Scott and I, and he said, you have to take care of yourself. You have to take care of yourself, your family. That's what's important. Take care of you. What do you want to accomplish? You know, what do you want your financial goal to be this year? How much of that debt do you want to pay off? What is next year going to look like, because you've accomplished all this year? And it's like, we just had this mind-blowing aha moment, because we're like, this is about what we want. This is about what vision we're creating for our family. That's what my mom did. That's how we give back. That's how we show you what's possible, is by really living the life that we create. So you guys have to think about these things, because these things matter. This is what drives you to get up out of bed every day, put your gear on, hand out a blitz card, wrap somebody. Not only that, that's what attracts people to you, for people to want to know who you are. I showed up at an event last night and this woman says, I had no idea who you were. You know, you've been connecting with me. I just didn't know. I mean, I know about It Works. And she was just like, so like throw up in the mouth. It was awesome to see that because even living in here in this Sarasota area for such a short period of time, that I am becoming the rap girl. That's the vision that I had. I want to be that rap girl. You want to be that rap girl or that rap guy that people see and know and want to do business with. That's your goal. Be that person. And I tell you what, there's plenty of us out there. There's 4 other ambassadors that live in this area. But again, I'm doing this. I'm blinders on, right? So I grew up watching my mom create that for us, create that for herself, create that for our family. And I remember the last job I had, I got fired. The very last job I ever had, I got completely taken off the schedule. This was 2 months before I left on a trip to Europe. I was going to study abroad, and my boss was paying me a lot because I was working my tail off, and I knew that I was commission-based. So the more clothes I sold, the higher my paycheck was. And she knew, and so she took me off the schedule because she was paying me too much. I was furious. I mean, I thought the walls were caving in. I was so mad. I was crying like Kennedy does when he hits his head. Like, I lost it. And I called my mom. How can she do this to me? You know, I was so mad. She goes, this is probably the best thing that's ever happened to you. And we don't know why yet, but this is probably the best thing that's ever happened to you. And it was, because after that, I thought, no one is going to dictate my future. Nobody is going to tell me how much money I can or cannot make, when I have to show up for work, and when I have to go home. Because if it were up to me, I would have left that store up until midnight. I'm like, I could have stole clothes till midnight, you know? That's the mentality that I had. And so when I was in college, this was my study abroad experience. I had a full ride. I mean, my mom paid for all my college. She paid for my study abroad, all cash. I walked out of school with absolutely no student loan debt. And it's because of It Works. So because I'm in college, because I was 21 years old, I realized, oh my gosh, my mom's paying for all this. It's because of what she's done that's allowed me to have this opportunity. And I've got no money in the bank. I was making minimal of what I could working retail. What am I going to do? And all my friends were graduating college. They're not able to get jobs. If they are getting a job, they're not getting paid very much because the economy had crashed. And here I am working in the fashion industry and going, oh my gosh, is this really what I want? So I started asking myself those questions. Now, some people I realize ask themselves those questions when they're in their mid 30s, 40s, 50s. My mom's friends are asking themselves that right now. They're going, whoa, I've been working at this job for, gosh, 25, 30 years, and I have no money in the account. They're starting to rethink. Well, I did that early. And I'm glad I did, because for the first time, even though I was so proud of my mom, I was so proud of what she accomplished. I had been to boot camps. I had been to what we now call One Team, One Missions. I had been to those events. I heard the stories, but I didn't see it for myself until this moment. And I said, Mom, I want to know what it's going to take for me to be successful with It Works. I want to see if I can do this. Do you really think I can? Just like so many of your potential distributors are thinking right now, looking at your posts on Facebook, can I really be as successful as Shannon? Can I really be as successful as Sandy? Can I really be successful with all these people that I see their posts? Is it really possible? They're wondering. And so I asked, I had the guts to ask, I wanted to change. And so I had a wrap party my first 3 weeks home from that trip, study abroad. And you know, guys, this is where it switched for me. this is what I want you to know, that this, it took action for me. It took for me to get bold enough, as scared as I was, as nervous as I was, as red in the face as I got, to have a wrap party by myself. I brought a friend with me. I was living 3 hours away from my mom. She didn't get in a car and come drive to launch me. Like, I did it on my own. And I think she like sent me a little care package in the mail, like some marketing materials that were like misspelled. Our product catalog at the time was misspelled, and we didn't have our colors or anything. It was priceless. So I think she sent me this little goodie bag in the mail of like marketing materials. But then I had my own product, because I used all the my own products. So I had like Confianza greens, defining gel wraps, Fat Fighter. And I thought, well, these are college girls. Let's see if they want anything. So I had this wrap party. I had 6 girls come. They all bought product, and they all became my customers. And these girls were lined up, pulling their shirts up, having me take pictures of them with the wrap on. And the thing that did it for me as a salesperson, as a, you know, background in my industry in fashion, these girls never once stepped foot in my store. They couldn't afford it. It was too intimidating. They would have never, they could have never bought, not even a sale item. Okay. But they came to the wrap party, and they all became my customers, and they wrapped. And I thought, I have a market. I've got a big market, because if these college girls want this, everybody's going to want this. I had to see that for myself. It wasn't just like going to a wrap party with my mom, or going to a One Team, One Mission, or going to a boot camp. It was me experiencing that for myself, which is what you have to do to build belief in your own business. You have to wrap somebody and see the results. You have to have a wrap party and put yourself in an uncomfortable situation if that's uncomfortable for you. You have to take guests to a One Team, One Mission. You have to put yourselves in these situations to experience success for yourself in order for your belief system in our company and in this industry to expand. And that's what I did. That's how I built my confidence in this. And so I started partying like crazy. I partied, partied. I was in the homes. I was in, you know, dorms of people's apartments. I was doing, and then that connected me to like local businesses, or I'd go set up in Gold's Gym for a couple hours on a Thursday night. And that got me connected with a salon or a spa or someone that worked in a certain business. I'd go set up in their shop. I did whatever I could that was affordable and easy because I was in college. I didn't have mom like dumping money for me to go do things. I had to do these things on my own. I was by myself. And in 1 year, double diamond, but I graduated with a 5-figure monthly check. 5 figures a month at 22 years old in my first year, because I busted my tail. I was determined. I felt like I had something to prove. I felt like I had to prove it to myself, to my old boss that fired me. I was like, I'll show you. And I think I did, you know. She since messaged me. It's so funny. And she's proud of me, you know. I think she knows what that did. It's pretty cool. So I want you guys to think about these things, because when I look at whenever our team, whenever we've, like for me, Ambassador, I was talking to Laura and Chase about this, because, you know, Chase is really ready to take his business to the next level. Like, he is all in. Him and Laura are fired up, excited about what this company has already done for their family. And we were having a conversation, and he said, you know, we partied our way to get you Ambassador, didn't we? I mean, you know, I partied my way to Double Diamond. And Laura partied to triple. And I'm like, yeah, it was like this light bulb went off. I went, yeah, we were in the homes. We were belly to belly. We were face to face. We were networking. We were doing whatever it took to be that rap girl, that rap guy. And it worked. It was more volume than ever. It was more rap sold than ever. It was more connections than ever, because we partied our way there. We didn't really have social media like we do today. Now we have it different. We can do both. But I'm telling you guys, there's nothing more powerful than getting people in a one-team-one mission room, putting a wrap on them, having a wrap party, connecting, doing one-on-ones. It's powerful. And Shannon, you know, because as a presidential diamond, you know what it took for you to get to presidential. And I texted you one day recently and I said, how did you do this without a nanny? Because we're transitioning between nannies. You have four kids. You have four children. And you're like, it was hard, but I did it. It was hard, but I did it. And you did. And so for you, hearing what I'm saying, what was it for you that got you to presidential? Because I know that everybody on this Zoom right now wants to go here. It's not like a little bit. It's like a jump. And you know what it takes. And it's that belly-to-belly action and those parties and those events. So talk a little bit about that, because I feel like this is where you and I really connect.
Yeah, I feel like basically everything I did, I was wanting to do things that would lead to enrollment. So anything and everything that would lead to enrollment. So I worked tables at festivals, but really I was trying to go to parties, do parties, because parties just built things. I mean, sometimes you would leave a party and you'd be like, wow, I may have only wrapped a couple people and walked away with no loyals, but that was very rare. Most of the time I was walking away with loyals, walking away with potential distributors, if not a distributor. And when I very first started, I wasn't even that good at it. I just, I'm opening the brochure and I don't even think I had a party pad when I first started. So I had a couple pages of notes and I just told people I was nervous and I had my notes with me and they just bear with me. I'm going to read them my notes so I wouldn't miss anything. And I think if you're just genuine and you're yourself, people can relate to that. And they appreciate that, And so by the end of the night, I was like, oh, yay, I have customers and I have people that are excited about what I'm excited about. So because I worked with excitement, because I talked about my business with excitement, it led to people being interested and wanting to know more info, which led to me scheduling parties, like you said. I definitely would not be presidential without partying. I mean, my goal, and always has been, but definitely that first year, my goal was to do at least one party a week. Obviously with four kids, I wasn't like trying to party every night of the week, but my goal was to do at least one a week. Cause if I could get four parties in a month, I mean, what? Like that would be amazing. So, and you don't think, you just don't know until you do it. Like you said, you just don't know. I mean, Kaye knows I get super nervous, I have anxiety. So like in putting myself in front of a group of people to talk about something that I didn't really know that much, I was nervous. But just like you said, if you force yourself to take some action, every time you do it, you get better at it. And you learn from yourself. Yeah. You learn what you can improve on. It's not a bad thing. I think I read somewhere it's failing forward. You can kind of call it failing, but it's not really failing because you're improving each time. So, that's hands down.
I just pulled up my calculator and I did some math really quick because this is how I think logically, right? So this is the green side of me for all of you. An average loyal customer spends $72 an order. An average. Okay. That's statistically, I'm not making that up. That's not coming from like my own personal, that is like across the board. It works across the board, $72. Let's say at a wrap party, you walk away, let's say eight people are in the room, six become loyal customers. You do a four a month. Like Shannon said, that's just four a month, one a week. That's an extra $1,728 in volume by yourself that you just generated on your team. Now, we're in the business of network marketing, so we're not alone once we have a team, right? So if you have four people on your team and they're doing that times four, you just added almost $7,000 in volume. So you get one loyal customer on Instagram that buys hair, skin, and nails because they saw your product model post for hair, skin, and nails. But then what? Now you have to really develop a relationship with them in order to get referrals. Or you have to go repeat and repeat and repeat and repeat and repeat that. Or you could have someone that you meet locally host a party for you and you're in the room in front of 8 to 10 people. and walk away with 6 customers.
And wrap cash.
And wrap cash. And another party. And an event. So here's a good scenario for you that I have a lot of these, but another aha moment. I'm a part of a mom's group in Sarasota. It's a mom's blog group. And we meet maybe every quarter, maybe every couple months. We first started all online. We did a Zoom like this and all met over Zoom. And then we had an event. And the first one was like super small. And everyone's like kind of awkward because you don't really know each other. And then the next one was like super fun. And we sat down. We were more intimate. We were talking. Well, I met this one girl. One girl. And we clicked. I invited her to my wrap party. She came, which I was like, wow, she came. Like, oh, she came, you know. I felt like I'd won the lottery. Turns out she's from Sarasota. She's lived here her entire life. So have her parents. She's so connected. So connected. She has referred me to more people that I am now going and having a one-on-one with, to wrap, to sign them up as a customer, to join the team, because that one person I invited to my wrap party, that she's not even hosted one for me yet. Like, that's a whole nother story. And now her mom's like super interested in the business. It is the coolest thing, because I stepped out and started meeting new people. And this is what Chase and I were talking about the other day. We had lunch and we had this meeting. And I said, you've got to join like a kayaking club or like a men's group in Sarasota. It's not that you go thinking, oh my gosh, I'm going to be like a cash cow. I'm going to meet all these people. They're all going to join my team. It's like, no, you've got to be people's friend. You've got to genuinely care about them. But boom, magic happens. Then before you know it, you're invited to something else. You're invited to a cookout. You're networking with the people in your gym. Chase was just networking with this group, and the gym has developed a beautiful relationship with the guy and his wife that are having a baby. He was invited to their baby shower. He's like, yes, I'm going to go. So these are the things that you think, or maybe you don't think, but some of you might think don't really matter. They're everything. This is the business of developing relationships and networking and being friendly and connecting with people. And you have to be that person that people want to be around. Like, I was sitting at the coffee shop today, asked this man, can I go to the bathroom? Can you watch over my stuff for me? And the guy was so nice. And he's like, he's talking about something fitness. And we're like, well, what do you do? So I start connecting and start interacting with him. Long story short, he's a personal trainer at this gym that does all these kids events like kickboxing and stuff. And it's like, so I started talking to him about the blog. And then I started talking to him about being a mom and how we're working out for our wedding. And it's like, one thing leads to another, gives me his business card. Wow, friends me on Facebook. Now I have somebody else to connect with. It's like, you guys have to think about these things and stop trying to do it all at one time. Relationships develop when you are consistent. And then it's like, all of a sudden you feel like all your seeds are planted and they're blossoming and these beautiful big trees and flowers are growing. And you're like, oh, that was all that work I did. And then all of a sudden you have all these enrollments and all these new customers and all these new distributors because of all the work you did leading up to that moment. It's like, that's the brilliance and the magic that you have to create in your business. And I was on a call with ambassadors, I think. Yeah, it was the ambassador call, and it was a Zoom, and Joel and Stephanie were talking about this very thing because they're number one income earners in our company. I mean, they are on fire. And Joel said, maybe the difference between us and you is that we see the value in creating 30, 60, 90 day relationships with people and then repeating, repeating, repeating. See, you all, and this is what he said, it was like such a slap in the face. And this was last fall. So this really clicked for me. I'm like, oh, I got to do that. You all build relationships for 30, 60, 90 days, then it all sprouts, but you forget to repeat that while it's all sprouting. Does that make sense? Because that was powerful for me. He's like, because you want the cycle to repeat itself. So that you've got 30, you're building relationships, 30, 60, 90 days, it blossoms. For those 30, 60, 90 days, you're going and you're blossoming. And now it's all starting to catapult and build. It's like a domino effect and build up on each other. So right now we're in that peak season. This is a really good time to think about this. This is our season. This is like a big deal time right now. You have to be developing these relationships, planting these seeds, really nurturing and loving these relationships so that they blossom for you. And as they're blossoming, you continue to repeat that cycle. That's the power of this industry. Like, you don't see my mom not talk about it works. You don't see my mom not boasting about her company or handing someone a Blitz card or communicate. She's always meeting new people. Oh, you'd be great in my business. I need to connect you with so-and-so. They live in your city and they're a leader. I need to connect you with my daughter. She would, you know, this is why she's so successful 17 years in or 16 years. I say 17 because it was December of 2000. So I'm off a month. But this is the beauty, guys, that you have to realize that matters so much about what you're doing right now. Because it is all about developing relationships. And you do not want to miss out on that opportunity for someone else to sprout up and say, well, I'm going to be that rap girl or that rap guy. And I'm going to go for it. And I'm going to develop these relationships. And then you watch them soar. Because I tell you what, that is what Joel and Stephanie have done. And they have paved the way for us. And that's what they do. They develop solid, amazing relationships with people. And those relationships stick. And then when that person is ready, they're ready for them. But they haven't given up along the way. And they haven't stopped continuing to build those relationships. You don't get attached. You just keep going. And then it sprouts. And it sprouts. And it sprouts. And I know that. I'm experiencing that right now. Shannon, anything on that?
It was interesting what you're saying about the building relationships, because it made me think about a few people just even from my first year, like back in 2012 when I was doing parties. And I still have people that, you know, are customers from my very first year that I've continued to have a relationship with, you know, meanwhile building the new. But they'll still refer, you know, people to me because they know that, you know, I've treated them well. There's been good customer care there. So I think, you know, building relationships obviously with your customers is important as well, you know, but I'm so thankful for that. And all of that, like you said, stems from that party because, you know, just like you said, I've been able to gather customers and, you know, even some distributors, some social media, but it just isn't quite the same as far as building that.
Yeah,
it takes a little bit longer, and I'm not saying it's a bad thing, but I just know, you know, I went triple within 13 months, and that was not from social media. I mean, it helps to post about my business and get the word out, but the face-to-face, you know, messaging via social media to book a party, but then the face-to-face and actually,
you know, that's a good point. It's so I want to say this because this goes back to another thing that Chase and I were talking about. Use social media to show people what you are doing. Use social media to pique their interest to what you're doing, you know, like when you're having that opportunity meeting or wrapping that person or in that wrap party or hosting that event or doing that little mini expo or whatever it is, you know, be that person of interest. Like, be interesting, be a little mysterious if you have to in that way, so people are like, what are you doing? Because, you know, Angus met a girl and she said, you know, I she saw his bracelet. He always wears the It Works bracelet. She said, you know, I see Facebook and it seems like a big giant ad. I know a lot of people that are doing this, but it's like ad after ad. No one's asked me. no one's actually reached out to me and asked me. No one's connected with me personally. No one. And that's the experience that Mom and I had when we were shopping in Palm Beach, 2 weeks ago after the One Team, One Mission. We were looking for her mother, the bride dress. And women said the same thing. I've seen this, but I've never really understood what it is. You know, it's like they see it on Facebook, they see it on Instagram, they see it, but they're just not sure. And it's giving that person that coupon and developing that interaction. So people are out there advertising for us all the way, right? All the time. We have to be that person that goes in and makes that personal connection. And I feel like that is where we're going to see a huge shift in our team this year. We already have. People are really building in the field. They're still doing online parties. They're doing their lives. I think going live is so brilliant. But that's because that's connecting more deeply with people. That's really showing people who you are, showing people how your life is. So for you know, when you think about this month, we are in momentum. I mean, corporate has put together some really amazing bonuses for us. These aren't just, Scott was like, what do you feel like's different? We were on a walk the other day. I said, you know what's different? It's like you can come in 3 months, make a bonus. You can come in 6 months and make a bonus. You can be in right now and make one in three or by March or make one in a couple more, whatever your going bonus is for you, and still come out ahead. Like there's longevity in this one. Like there's longevity. This is going to go on all year. So I told him, I'm like, my objective with our team is to see this all year long, just growth, 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 that your paychecks grow, your income grows, you promote and rank, that you get serious about this, that you really look at this like this is a business. I have goals. I have objectives. I have family things that I want to accomplish. I have debt that I want to pay off. I have a trip that I want to go on, and that you get serious about what it is that you want, and that you decide right now where it is you've got to go in order for you to take you there, and you work your tail off for that. I'm not talking just run to a promotion and then give up, get that bonus and that's it. I'm talking about true longevity, a solid team, a solid business, a solid promotion, get your money, get your well-deserved money and your bonus, but make a decision today that you're going to promote. You have to first decide. You're not going to know where all these people are going to come from. You're not going to know where all these loyal, that is not the how. Is not up for you to decide. You first have to decide and take ownership of what it is. Even if you're brand new and you're like, I am an executive, you need to own that and you need to go out and get your two people and keep promoting and keep running until all that volume's in place and start strategizing yourself to Ruby. And it's going to come from loyal customers, from adding new team members who purchase product. We get paid on volume. So how are you going to generate volume? That's what you guys need to go out and do. Okay. You need to first decide what it is that you want. You want diamond, you need to be running so that not only, like I'm talking about, you're running through the finish line. Okay. Here's the finish line and you plow through it. Like you're over here at the end of it, right? Like you go so fast and so far that you run through the finish line and almost topple over because you're going to double. You have so much momentum that your team wants their diamond bonuses. They want their emerald. They want Ruby. They want to promote and build too. So this is like, we're thinking long-term. Long term, go get your bonus. Go get your bonus. This isn't like something that ends in April. This is all year. This is a really big deal. For those of you that weren't a part of our team before, not a part of it works, these bonuses ended in like April. Now they're all year. They're all year. And all you have to do is have 4 loyals to qualify. Go get your 4 loyals. That's four people. You know, I mean, Shannon, I think that this is like the biggest, when I was talking to Scott about this, I'm like, this is like a really big deal. Because these are long-term goals too. This is short-term, long-term. This is like, you're really in control here. Like when you decide that you want something and you're willing to do what it takes to get it, the how will all fall in place. You know,
it's, the company too is like, it's like they show you that you're rewarded for that longevity, for continuing to work and continuing to build. It's just kind of
it concept.
They don't have to do that. They don't have to give you a bonus when you get to double or triple. Or I didn't get one when I got to double. What if I'd stopped?
I didn't have one. I was making five figures a month at double.
Right?
Guys, that was all natural. Like, what if there was a bonus on top of that?
Yeah.
Like, you never know. It's crazy.
It's really awesome because it's like our comp plan alone is a bonus. You know, you're already getting really good results and compensation from the comp plan. But I love how the company does, you know, they say, listen, like, it's worth it to us for you to stay in it this long, for you to see that it's worth it to you. Like, because ultimately this is about you and your success and where this company can take you. So I think it's amazing what they've offered. I'm excited.
You never know who's going to come in your business and run. Mm-hmm. You don't know. It's you think maybe it's that person you sponsor tonight. Maybe it's someone they sponsor. You never know who's going to come in your business and run. So you've got to have that like blinders on mentality. You're like laser focused on your goal. So again, you're still not even comparing it to what people on your team are doing. You are focused on your goal and your path as if you're filling in that chart yourself. Doesn't mean fill it in yourself. It just means you have to run like you're filling it in yourself. It takes high energy, full focus, and just a strong sense of knowing. And if you don't quite have that yet, you're going to develop that through those action steps. Because I can tell you, I didn't quite understand it all when I started. I really didn't have the confidence. Like Shannon said, it's like a little bit of anxiety, a little bit of nervousness, uncertainty. This comes from taking action. And then your confidence develops. And then you're expressing this to your team one day and saying the same things. It all comes from just making a decision. Just a strong decision. Just like something so simple. You know, if you want to make something for dinner, you get an idea of what you want to make. You go to the store, you buy the stuff, you come home, and you make it. It's not that complicated, right? But you complicate this in such a way that it's any different. No, you're just making a decision and you're taking action to go towards that goal. And you're going to go, this is the same thing, but you just have to get really jazzed and excited. It's like when you make that meal, you can almost taste it. You know, like I made enchilada soup last night. I could taste it as I was like buying ingredients and looking at that, you know, recipe. And then it's like, I tasted it and it was even better than I thought. It was so good. And it's like, that's the concept here, you guys. You got to feel this whole thing out, have fun with it, decide that you're going for it, and take ownership of it. And it doesn't matter what anybody says. They don't pay your bills. They don't know your dreams. They don't understand your why. I don't care where you are in this business, Ambassador Diamond, top income earner, no one will ever understand your why. No one will ever understand my why like we do. No one. Not even Scott will really understand my why like I do. Kennedy will never understand my why like I do. Only I will really understand that. That's okay. That is your work to put your blinders on and go get it. I don't know any other way in this business. That's what's taken me as far as I've gotten now. It's going to continue to take me all the way to the top. You guys, this is what I know. Shannon, I mean, what else? This is it.
It's just like what you said, the perfect combination of excitement and consistency. And you guys, you're not in business by yourself, but this is your business, you know? And so we'd love to be able to do it for you, but we can't. We're doing our own business. So, you know, but I love that this can be something that we all have fun with and work, and, you know, we're working together as a team, you know, and it's just, I mean, there's something magical that happens, especially during promotion months.
But now's the time to decide.
Right. Now's the time to really just kind of, you know, what do they say? Plant your flag and make a decision about what you want out of just this month alone. And obviously this year, but really kind of what Mark was saying when he was talking about writing a letter to yourself. You know, write that letter to yourself. Where do you see yourself this time next year?
You know, what does that look like? What could that possibly be for you? I think that you guys it's not that you just sit around and dream. It's more than just dreaming about what you want. It's actually being able to taste it, to feel it, to smell it. It's like if your dream is to live on the beach, what is that going to feel like? Go outside and feel the breeze in your face and take yourself there. It's going to feel like that, but it's going to be probably a little bit more wind. You're going to be able to smell the sand. It's going to have that kind of sunscreeny type smell. You can look down and see you can look down and see your brightly colored painted toenails and your towel, and you got your big hat on, and your kids are running around, and your spouse is with you, and you're on the beach, and you're there. Or if it's a house, it's like Scott and I, we know we want to upgrade our house. So whenever we take Kennedy, we really don't have the desire to do it now. We have the desire to do it one day. But we take Kennedy and go on these bike rides to these neighborhoods over here. And we go and look and go, oh, wonder how much that one costs. Or, oh my gosh, I could see Kennedy running through that yard with his friends or in our future kiddos. And it's like the house that Shannon's living in right now, they drove by it and drove by it and drove by it and visualized their kids in that house, and they got the house. She wanted a yard for her kids. That took visualization. That took her actually putting herself there. She had to put herself there. These are the things that you need to do so that you're like, that's what Mark says, write a letter to yourself. What does that look like? What kind of conversations are you and your spouse having a year from now? Is it that you're having the conversation that honey, this year we worked so hard and it works that we got all those bonuses. We got $100,000 in bonuses that now we're able to take the dream trip to Europe. We could go for a whole month. Let's go for a whole month. Let's start planning it. You're actually a year from now experiencing this because of all the hard work you put into your business this year. This is what they're talking about. And this is what I say going full circle. This is why you want to be so proud of yourself this year. You just want to be proud of yourself. If it's that you got some bonuses and your team grew, your leadership's excelling, people are really starting to appreciate you and respect you and look up to you. What is it that you want? All of that matters, and that matters to you. It doesn't have to matter if we even understand it for you. It's that you understand it for yourself, and we're going to cheer you on all the way through. All the way through. Only, again, you can really fully feel that for yourself. That's not anyone else's job. That's your job. But this celebratory process of it all, and you promoting through these ranks, and you getting your recognition, and you being on that white couch, you running across stage, you being in the VIP section at conference, whatever it is for you, just take ownership of that. Like, just love it. And that's what we're talking about. It all starts there. I really want you guys to look back even at this Zoom a year from now and say, oh, I'm so glad I started dreaming. I'm so glad I allowed myself to do that, and really see where it takes you. Come on.
Me too.
Yeah. Scott's doing a facial tonight. He did a peel earlier. Cleanse your face, and we'll put it on after I'm done. Just a minute.
Product of the
We're getting wedding ready.
That's awesome.
She's like, can I put my pink
one? I have to hide mine from John, so I understand.
I put one on the other day and put my like eye masks on, like my that darkens the whole room, and I went out. I'm like, I love our facials.
Listen, I so appreciate you being on with us tonight. I mean, I know beyond a shadow of a doubt, like our team is super thankful for you and your time. I mean, I know that we're ready, and you know, we want you to be Black Diamond, of course. So that's going to take our team going ambassador, I'm sure. That's a small part of a very big picture.
Well, and I know how much ambassador means to you, Shannon. And I know that you are so capable and so much more of that. You are the leader that this team needs to go ambassador. And that's going to just mean that you all are promoting, you're accomplishing your goals, you're setting yourself up for that, or whatever your success point is in this right now, because it's going to change once you get there. It's going to grow, it's going to evolve, and it's a beautiful thing. It's a beautiful process.
It really is.
Yeah, I know you're the leader for them for that. So we're doing it. That's all I can say.
Yep, we're just going to make it happen. So hopefully everybody that's on tonight, post your aha moments on our team page as well from tonight's call. And Kaye, if you've recorded it, if you can share it with me, I can share it with you.
Yeah, I'll load it up to the training segment of my YouTube for you guys, and you can have it.
Thank you so much.
Okay. Bye, you guys. Thank
you. Bye, everybody.